After season 3, season 4 is probably my second favorite Columbo season. But remember, season 3 had quite a rocky start. So does the 4th season opener and exercise in fatality fare any better? Milo Janis, played by TV tough guy Robert Conrad, is a fitness guru with his own health spa franchise. It's got one hell of a catchy theme song.
Keep in trim, healthy and slim, Milo Janis, you're in the swim.
As we all know, Janus is also the name of a Roman god known for being two-faced, and Milo Janis is certainly two-faced. Turns out he's overcharging franchisees for gym equipment made by companies that he himself owns. He deposits the profits in offshore bank accounts. One gym owner, Gene Stafford, knows he's being ripped off and is determined to get to the bottom of it.
It's here someplace, and I'm gonna stay at this desk till I find it. I don't care if it takes a weekend, a week, a month, but I'm going to find it.
Well, that's an invitation to be murdered if ever I heard one. And murdered he shall be. Janis has a habit of recording all of his phone calls and plans to use this as part of his alibi. He also has a master key to all his franchise buildings, which allows him to sneak easily into the gym after it's closed. Why did Janis wait until his victim was facing him and holding a pot of boiling hot coffee to then try and kill him? Never heard of the element of surprise, Milo? He chases Gene down in one of the most intense and chilling murder scenes the show ever produced. What is up with everyone dying so quickly in this universe? Anyway, what happened there was Milo crushed his windpipe and then makes it look like a fatal weightlifting accident. He heads over to his beach house to establish his alibi, as he's invited some friends over to peep a horror movie.
X-rated and uncut.
Wonder what they ended up watching. Check out his big projector screen, by the way. Man, I wish I had one of those. I'd watch Columbo all day on one of those bad boys. He even stages a fake phone call with Gene to make it seem he's still alive, thereby establishing an inaccurate time of death for investigators to go off of. Speaking of investigators, Columbo shows up to the crime scene, but he's barely functioning. Despite being borderline comatose, the lieutenant is eagle-eyed as ever, quickly spotting several little things that don't add up. Why would Stafford eat so much Chinese food before working out? Eating a lot before strenuous exercise is generally advised against. Why are there brown scuff marks on the freshly waxed floor, almost as if someone was chasing Stafford across it? And why is there spilled coffee on the floor of Stafford's office? Columbo knows he has his man the second he meets Janis and spots a burn mark on his wrist. Did anyone else notice that when the police are investigating the crime scene, there's some old guy hanging out in his underwear? Who is this guy? Is he supposed to be a gym member? Shouldn't the gym be closed? You know, what with the guy dying in it and everything. Robert Conrad's performance is solid in this. I don't find him as magnetic in the part as the Cassidys or the Culps of this world.
Oh, you're kidding.
But he makes for a decent antagonist to the lieutenant. Milo Janis may be built like an Adonis, but he has the scruples of Hades. As I said, Janis's name is similar to that of the two-faced Roman god, but if you take the J off of Janis, you get anus, and this guy sure is an asshole.
Can I do something?
He totally loves himself, has little time for Columbo, and Conrad's icy death stare makes him pretty intimidating.
No, understand?
The highlight of the episode is when Columbo goes to visit Milo at his beach house and his secretary opens the door. Yes, I know I always use that song. All the other good sexy songs are copyrighted. This is Jessica Conroy, Milo's secretary and girlfriend, played by Gretchen Corbett. I'm surprised Columbo even spotted the burn mark on Milo's wrist while she's strutting around like this. On the flip side, the episode's low point comes in the excruciatingly long scene of Columbo at Tricon Industries. He's there to try and find some information about Lewis Lacey, an accountant or some such who may know something about Janice's shady dealings. Rather than simply telling him what he needs to know, the snooty lady at the counter insists on using a newfangled machine to print out all the information on Lacey the company has on file. A funny idea for a scene, but did it need to last 6 fucking minutes? It starts out as amusing, sure, but quickly overstays its welcome. And after all that, the information Columbo eventually does glean from Mr. Lacey isn't of that much importance to the overall plot. Could have just cut the subplot out and you wouldn't lose that much. The now infamous Tricon detour is one of the most egregious examples of padding being added to a 70-minute script in order to produce a 90-minute episode. Colin Wilcox plays Ruth Stafford, Gene's ex-wife who's as boozy as Vicky Hayward or Helen Stewart's mother before. She might be even more boozy.
Can I get you a drink?
No. No, thank you.
Well, how about some wine?
No.
Are you sure I'm having some?
Like Columbo, she becomes convinced of Milo's guilt, but doesn't handle it as well, trying to off herself by ingesting a potentially lethal mix of pills and Even more alcohol. She lives, but man is Columbo pissed. At the hospital, he has an explosive confrontation with Janice where the veil of politeness is totally discarded.
You don't care whether she lives or dies. As a matter of fact, she's drinking because of you, because she thinks you're responsible for the death of her husband. You want to know something? So do I.
Columbo's not pulling his punches anymore. This is a great scene where Columbo lets the killer know just what he really thinks of him. Just like he did to Dr. Mayfield back in season 2. What is it about being around hospitals that puts Columbo in such a foul mood? Columbo's gonna take some extra satisfaction in finally nailing Janice, and he does so with one of the series' best ever final clues. Janice claims that, during his phony phone call with Jean, the dead man said that he was wearing his gym clothes and about to work out. But the last people to have left the gym last saw Jean wearing his business clothes. Of course, Janice himself changed the clothes on the body, but how can Columbo prove this? Well, the answer lies in something you probably do every day. No, not taking a shit, and no, it's not jerking off to this scene either.
Oh my god. I'm sorry, man.
It's tying your shoelaces. Well, not your shoelaces, but Gene Stafford's shoelaces. As the lieutenant explains. And since only Janice knew that Stafford was in his gym clothes, only he could have changed the clothes and tied his shoes. How brilliant is that? Something so small, such an otherwise insignificant detail that anyone else would have overlooked. But not Columbo. Never Columbo. In fact, Peter Falk himself was so proud of this gotcha that he made an impromptu appearance on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson to talk about it. What you're seeing is not that episode. The clip used to be on YouTube, but it's since been deleted and I haven't seen it re-uploaded anywhere else. If anybody out there has this clip that I'm talking about, please let me know. I would love to see it again. The Columbo File, a Columbo fan site which is the definitive resource for all things Columbo, holds an annual poll to decide the top 10 very best Columbo episodes as voted for by fans. For the last couple of years, An Exercise in Fatality has found its way into that top 10. I don't think it's that good, it's not even top 20 for me personally, but it is very solid. There's some ropey parts, some fun parts, and some exceptional parts. Oh, and there's that irritatingly catchy Milo Janis jingle. Come on then, all together now. Feeling flat, tired and fat, Milo Janis is where it's at. Keeping trim, healthy and slim, with Milo Janis you're in the swim. Your new life is waiting to begin at Milo Janis. Get in shape, we'll see you through thick and thin. Everybody start the day, shed pounds away to start with your commonwealth. The only thing you have to gain is your health. Okay, alright, I apologize for that. See you next week.